Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. For those who already subscribed, for those who didn't, well, welcome. Today I'm doing Q&A of the most asked questions. I have them here. I felt like it's probably gonna help us to like connect and for you to get to know me better. If you have any questions, I'll be happy to answer them, and you can write them down below in the comments. So let's go. Okay, so I will start with the simplest questions of all, just because I get them a lot. How old am I? I'm 26 years old. I was born March 1994, March 20 to be exact. Soon my birthday is coming up. I'm Pisces, I'm last day of Pisces. So I'm kind of on the cusp of being Pisces and Aries. But I feel like I'm more of an Aries, but I'm sensitive like Pisces, so I guess I got the best of both signs. How tall am I? I'm 173, which is what, 5'9"? Yeah. I'm kind of not so tall for being a model, and that's always been a struggle in an industry for me, especially when I just started. Where I'm from? I am from Russia. To be exact, I'm from Far East Russia, the city called Khabarovsk. I moved out of there completely when I was 17. I moved to New York. Before 17, I was based in my hometown, but I was still traveling abroad for work. Here, I mean, it's quite small town. I mean, for Russia, it's small. For a regular scale, I feel like it's not so small. It's 500,000 people. It's very, very cold, so it gets to minus 30 degrees during winter time. And we have 3 months of summer, so that's really the only warm time we get. Okay, so how long I've been living in USA? I've been living in USA for 8 years. I've been living four and a half in New York, and basically 3.5 years in Miami. Where do I live now? Well, I just answered, I live in Miami, in the sunniest, warmest place in the world, coming from one of the coldest places. Seems like a perfect transition. It's funny because a lot of times when I was a kid, I dreamed to live by the ocean and in the warm weather. So I feel like I manifest that in my life. Am I vegan? I get a lot of this question because I feel like I post a lot of content on my Instagram. You can find my Instagram name right here. If you didn't subscribe on me yet, feel free to find me on Instagram. Let's connect. I am not vegan, but I love vegan food. I feel like it's such a fun food to cook. I love especially vegan desserts. During quarantine, I took like a professional course for raw vegan desserts, which was really fun, and it kept me so busy and entertained throughout the whole quarantine. My husband was super happy for my new hobby because every day he had a new cake. How I was scouted as a model, it's actually a long story, and I would love to do a full separated video on my old modeling career story. But just to give you a quick idea, my best friend, she just said like, oh, why don't we try to find you an agency in Moscow? Let's take it more serious. Let's just give it a shot. So we did our research on the internet, like which agency was the best. And she just took her camera. She had like a professional kind of camera, and she shot pictures of me. And we sent those pictures to a Moscow agency called Cherry Models. Answered to me right away saying, okay, we're ready to see you, why don't you come to Moscow, and you know, we will get to know you, we'll take snaps of you, and we'll see where it's gonna take. Best part about being a model, I traveled 20 countries, which, you know, I'm 26 years old right now. 20 countries when you're 26 years old, I'm sorry, it's a lot of countries to visit. And I'm so blessed that I've seen so many beautiful places around the world thanks to modeling. I think also great part about being a model, you can earn money really young, really quick, and really good amounts. So I think that's a great opportunity and I'm so thankful for this. But I think in the same time, it's also challenging when you are earning money at such a young age and don't have any experience on how to manage this money. I feel like you can also lose them very quickly. So it's very important to be smart about the money you earn. Also, I think best part about being a model is meeting a lot of talented people in the industry, you know, creative people. I think it's definitely built up creativity in me. Taste, I learned how to do makeup, I learned how to do my hair. I mean, I learned a lot from modeling. Is modeling competitive and am I friends with models? It's very competitive business. I think it's so many beautiful girls in the industry and so little actually makes it to being something and earning something. So it's definitely a very competitive business. Couple of model friends that are good friends to me. I felt like when I was when I was in New York and modeling like full time, obviously now I have a family and I have a lot of like friends that are having babies. So it's like, you know, since I became a mom, I kind of gained another circle of friends. But when I was in New York and I was modeling full time, I felt like I didn't really have time to like hang out and, you know, go out and go to lunch. Even, you know, I was working non-stop. Even if when I was not working, like I was still doing something like workouts, or, you know, just wanted to chill on the bed simply because I was like busy the other days. So I felt like I could never like keep up with the, you know, friendship really, because every time the girls will like invite me once, twice, three times, you know, on the fourth time they don't invite me anymore because I always say no. One of the popular questions. How I got VS Show? Well, VS Show was a long way for me to get there. So I worked for, I started with the Pink Line. I worked for catalogs for the Pink Line for half a year. Then they switched me on shooting catalogs for the main line. And I worked there for another probably almost a year. But yes, basically I went through casting, through a regular casting that every model goes to. I mean, not every, but every model have an opportunity to go to. First year they told me no. They didn't even allow me to go to the main casting because there is basically a two castings. Like one is a pre-casting, second one is a main casting. So on the first round they didn't even allow me to go to the main casting. There was like one guy that was doing pre-casting, and then there was four people that were doing a main casting. So first person seemed like didn't like me at all, probably because I was too commercial. I've been told that he was more focused on picking more of a fashion tall girls for a VS Show, so I was not fitting that standard. I was working for this brand for almost 2 years and I felt like I'd have a chance to at least go to main casting. And so I went to my agency and I said, listen guys, you have to find out the reason why he didn't let me go to the main casting. I want exact reason. So they came back to me and they said that he said that I was not in shape and also that my walk wasn't too confident. So for the next year, I was working out so hard. I was losing so much weight for the next casting. I hired a trainer that was like a bodybuilder trainer. Here, I was waiting for a year. I went there and on the pre-casting, he told me again, the same thing. You are not made for VS Show. You're too short, you know, you're too whatever. So I went to the agency and I said to them, listen, you have to call them back and say that I will be on a make casting. I don't care what they think because I've been working out and preparing for this casting for the entire year. I lost so much weight. I practiced on my walk. So basically I fixed all the problems from a previous year that seemed like problems. So long story short, I made it to the main casting and I got the show. So, and I think this taught me that sometimes you just have to be persistent, and sometimes you shouldn't be scared for asking things that you think are meant to be for you. Another question that is kind of same type, how I got Sport Illustrated. I got Sport Illustrated to casting. She liked me, we talked, she took pictures of me, and then she booked me for the next magazine shoot. So I am absolutely blessed for being working for this brand for already 3 years straight. If I wouldn't be a model, what would I do? Always dreamed to travel a lot. So, and it's funny enough, my uncle is a pilot still. He works for a very big airline in Moscow, which we were very proud of him for making it from my hometown and being so successful in his career and pursuing his dream from an early age. I think this example really kind of sticked to me, and I still like remember so clearly this story that I think he was an inspiration for me in a way of like, okay, like I can stand strong with my opinion of what I want in life and I can just go for it. So that I will be a stewardess, and I saw that stewardess job will allow me to travel the world and, you know, maybe move from my hometown. So I think that looking back, probably a stewardess, but I don't know, you know, where the life would take me, you never know. Next one. How did I meet my husband? Well, that's another very long story. I have such a long story to everything, I'm sorry guys. But actually I met my husband for the very, very first time. I mean, when we really like saw each other first time. It was, I think in 2015 maybe, yeah. So we met in a strip club. Not the best place to meet, I know. But listen, we were there because we were watching a boxing match. Pasquet and Mayweather, yes. So we were watching that match, and there was a screening room, big screening room. So it was a lot of us, and we just rented a room there. We were watching boxing match. We kind of end up like two couples, you know, me with my boyfriend and him with his girlfriend. We end up sitting next to each other, and apparently he remembered me from that time. It was so dark, honestly, I did not remember him too well. He thinks I'm lying about this, but because he thinks that first time you see him, it's impossible to forget him. But I'm not lying, I'm telling you the truth, I do not remember him. He broke up with his girlfriend and he became single. I still was with my boyfriend. And he basically convinced our mutual friend to invite me on her birthday and say it was a girl's night out so my boyfriend can stay at home. I showed up there and it wasn't a girl's night out. He was there. Of course, he was all over me, trying to make friends with me and being funny. That night we kind of had a friendly like talk, and you know, from that night I remembered him already because he made it clear about himself. That was the end of our first meeting. We never exchanged the numbers, we never met after that. With my ex-boyfriend, we were going to vacation in Greece, and my ex-boyfriend and my husband, they have apparently a lot of mutual friends. And basically he found out somehow that I was going with my ex-boyfriend to Greece, and he quickly organized his trip to Greece too, just to meet there by chance. So he did this house party, he invited us all, and of course the door opens and he's there, and I'm just like standing there so shocked. And that from that night, I think it became very clear to me that he was targeting me. The day I broke up with my ex-boyfriend, he appeared. And it's funny because after I broke up, I wasn't feeling so great, and I went to Australia for a shoot. my agent called me and he said, well, listen, I have a shoot in Australia. They pay well. I know it's far. Do you want to go to Australia? And I said, well, yes, I want to go to Australia. I really want to go to Australia. I've been there before. I love Australia. And this is exactly what I needed after my breakup. So I flew there. And when I was in the airport, Valeria texted me, and he texted me on, he DM'd me on Instagram because I posted a picture, and he said, oh, you're going to Australia? And I said yes, and he's like, oh cool, will you go on a first date with me if I come to Australia? And I just said, ha ha ha, sure, thinking that it was a joke. The next day I received a picture from him, welcome to Australia. He basically took a ticket the same day and flew all the way to Australia to have our first date, and since then we've been together whenever I basically was just, that was it. We were together, we understood that we're meant to be with each other, we got along so well. Thanks to him, thank you Valeria for being so persistent too, like me with my VS show. So you see guys, that works. If I want to have more kids, I love kids, I always wanted to be a mom. Yes, I definitely want to have more kids. Ideally, I want to have three. That's how I imagined it to myself. But I'll go with the flow. We have one now. Maybe in a year or so, I will be ready to have a second one. Who knows? And maybe the third one along the way, you know, further away. But I think I want two kind of close to each other, and then the third one maybe later on. So guys, I think that was 15 most asked questions I get on a regular basis. I hope you enjoyed this conversation, and if you have any questions, please feel free to write them below. I will answer to all of them. Thank you for being here with me on my channel. If you did not subscribe yet, please do. So thank you guys, and see you in the next video.